for the applications that they had, the risks that were posed to operators were greater than any of the risks that might be introduced with a piece of automation.
Now you can start to look more holistically at how is this cobot making the entire workplace safer.
We're trying as hard as we can to make the life as easy as possible for the integrator.
Hi, my name is Joe Campbell, and I'm very happy to welcome you to the next edition of the Roundtable series, where we bring automation experts in to talk about a specific topic. Today's topic is deploying a cobot, which I think you'll find very interesting. We have brought together a panel of experts that have incredible knowledge of the space, and we're going to have a very good session. I'd like to introduce them. First, on my left is Roberta Nelson-Shea. She's the Global Compliance Officer for Universal. Michael Hirtberg is the Regional President for Northern Europe. Josh Polly, Founding Partner for Vectus Automation, and David Brandt, Technical Officer in Universal. Looking forward to a good session today, folks. The collaborative robot market has experienced incredible growth over the recent years. It's really unprecedented. It is the fastest growing segment in factory automation. Michael, I'd like to hear your perspective on what's driving that growth in Northern Europe.
Well, the key driver at the moment is labor shortage. It's definitely one of the areas where we do see quite a challenge. I reckon it's possibly also the same in all areas of the world at the moment. So that is a major key driver.
Josh, you're seeing the same, I'm sure.
Yeah, it remains the number one, you know, and I think that we're seeing a lot of, you know, increase in quality, increase in productivity, but it's all driven by, I can't just hire away my problems anymore, right? That's not as much of an option as maybe it was before.
Now, I think both of you are active in small and medium-sized companies, and that is a really significant change for collaborative automation. You agree with that?
Yeah, I mean, I think the biggest thing that we've seen is, you know, a lot of our customers call us and it's, you know, hey, I've looked at traditional automation many times before in the last couple decades, right? It's this hurdle, cost, footprint, mm-hmm. flexibility, programming time, training, all that. And you stack all those up and it becomes too much for some of those small, medium enterprises to get over, I think, right? And so we're definitely seeing that on the, hey, we're breaking down those hurdles. You know, we're bringing them down to a level that folks can get over, right? And so that's been really, really exciting to help those small and medium enterprises out.
So Roberta, it is very interesting that we're kind of opening up new horizons in automation with this new class of customers, smaller companies that have really never automated. What kind of guidance do you give them as they enter the automation field?
Very typically, no guidance because they don't even ask. And that's not meant to be flippant. It really is, they're getting into something and they're feeling their way through it. We do offer our academy courses, which actually do handle a reasonable portion of what might come up and what they need to understand. And our robots are smaller size, smaller payload. And so in the scheme of things, for the applications that they had, the risks that were posed to operators were greater than any of the risks that might be introduced with a piece of automation. And they learn to use it. They learn to use it well.
David, you've been instrumental in kind of developing some of those safety protocols and safety functions in our control structure. Could you speak to them just a little bit?
Yeah, sure. So we have a lot of built-in safety functions, basically designed to enable the integrator to safely integrate the robot as easily as possible. Of course, you base everything off the risk assessment of the application, and then you can adjust the safety functions. I think one of the things that are really unique about UI is also the amount of work around the safety functions, making them easy to use. So an example could be that you set some speed limit in a safety function, then you don't need to reprogram your application if you change the speed setting. It'll automatically adjust to avoid nuisance stops and so on. So that's just an example. We have that for all the safety functions. There's a lot of usability built into that as well. Mm-hmm. We're trying as hard as we can to make the life as easy as possible for the integrator.
And so that they use it right.
Yes.
Right?
They
don't just work around it. No. They use it right. Yeah,
exactly.
They use it correctly.
Yeah. I have a little funny story here. We went to quite a big company in Denmark who's within the pharmaceutical industry. And we were told by the distributor, we went with the distributor, and he said, you know, you got to be aware of one thing. Safety board here, they're going to kill you.
That so, doesn't sound safe.
No, exactly. I was quite nervous. So we went in there, and they actually assembled the whole company, all the process engineers and everybody. There's 40 people in there. And we were sitting, we were presenting, doing our the thing we do and presenting the robots, you know. And in the end, I could not kick out the board of safety because there were the last three guys standing there playing with the robot. And saying, gosh, we really got to go. We've got to pack it up. But it just shows one thing, that there is maybe a mindset sometimes because they're not familiar with the technology. But I think that's the beauty of the product, isn't it? That once you play with it, you understand it, and you're talking about the 17 safety features. It's safe. Mm-hmm. You know, you can... Don't worry, it's okay.
You still have to do a risk assessment yes. and configure the product properly.
Okay. Yeah, sorry.
What I think is so cool too, especially from a system integrator's perspective, is that when you get the safety right, when it's a green light, when it's good to go, and it's because UR's made it easy, and to your point, it's made it easy to the point where it's used, right? It's not worked around, it's used, it's not jumpered out, it's used properly. When you've got that, now you can start to look more holistically at how is this cobot making the entire workplace safer, right? And so what we hear from customers, what we see is that, particularly in the welding applications, you know, if you give the cobot the boring weldments and it's doing the welding, you're removing that welder from the welding fumes, right? Which is a problem for manual welders, right? So you're getting them farther away from the fumes. That's awesome for workplace safety, but it's because the cobot safety was done right first, right? You look at welding too, what we hear and see is that, you know, you make better welds in the weld shop, you need to grind them less in the post operation, right? Grinding is miserable. Grinding, it's dangerous. I can personally attest, you know, big old angle grinders, if you can reduce the amount of that going on in the entire factory, that cobot is contributing to the overall improvement of safety in the workplace.
Absolutely.
I think that's super powerful.
How many welders are populating workplaces now? That's like the lost art. We don't have enough welders.
Yeah.
So we have to use one welder to teach all of these robots to do what used to be 10 welders.
Yeah. And now you've got a tool that can maximize productivity
right. while that person,
of a single welder. Right?
Yes, while that person is exposed to fewer risks.
Exactly.
It's fabulous.
And the person loves it too because they hate doing the boring weldments.
Right.
Nobody wants to weld the dinky little brackets all day, right?
So I think if you look at a contract fab shop, you know, I think the whole tone of the shop changes when they start to automate. And I think we talked earlier about workplace safety. I think that's a big driver. Do you see the same?
Yeah, you know, and I think there's the tone of the facility and how it's that paradigm shift of how can we use this tool more, right? Because not only is it boosting productivity, but it's improving the workplace overall on, hey, I'm getting away from the fumes. I'm not having to do the boring weldments anymore. I'm not as tired at the end of the day holding that welding torch, you know, and we can reduce grinding and all these things that really just lifts the entire facility up by improving that operation in the weld shop when you can.
Now, I don't have data on it, but I have been told by more than one plant manager that it is easier to hire once you have cobots deployed in your factory. Have you seen that? Have you seen that, Michael?
You know, it's funny that you say so because we have had the universal robots are, you know, attracting quite a lot of young people, students, you know, from the universities, tech. But the funny thing is that what we do see is a lot of these young people come out actually saying to us, you know, I'm not going to work for a company who does not have a collaborative robot, who does not have robot technology. So I think that makes it even more, you know, focused that, you know, we don't want to work for somebody who does not have that technology on board. And that's good. I mean, not just for us, but for the entire industry that has so much focus on it. Also because that tedious work, the health and safety is a huge thing. So I think that's really something that we do see quite a lot. And a generation that's coming up right now are much more, you know, focused on that side also.
And we absolutely see that. It's used as a recruiting tool. Our customers tell us that all the time of, hey, we were able to bring in an intern from a local high school, intern from a community college, you know, a welder, a grinder that wanted to upskill because of this cobot, right? And I think it all goes back to that mindset of the tool, right? Like you come up to me and you're like, hey, Josh, you want to weld 500 of these parts today? And I'm like, I don't know, you know, but it's, you come to me and you say, hey, Josh, we've got this cobot tool for welding or palletizing or machine tending or whatever the application may be. Do you want to figure out how to leverage that to weld these 500 parts a day? sign me up.
Well, I'd like to thank all of you for being here. We had a really, really good session. Let's see if we can find an excuse to do another one sometime in the future. Thank you very much.
Thank you.